Let's talk about some of the unique features of coding, debugging, and testing an ACE module. First of all, there are three main sections in the ACE-generated code, whether you're using Visual Basic 6 or VisualBasic.net. And they are basically have an area for calculation. In VB6, it's called the actual performance equations, and in .NET, it's called ACE calculations. That's the subroutine where you will be placing most or all of your code. We also have two other small sections that are provided for you, and it's an area that you can put special code when the module initializes or when it terminates, and we have those areas both in the VB6 and VB Studio environments, and those are sometimes used if you need to do extra steps at the beginning or after an ACE module runs. But whichever version you use, you're going to have these three sections, and you really shouldn't modify code that's outside these sections. The code that's outside these sections is a lot of boilerplate and things that ACE needs to run, and you can break things very easily by modifying sections that are outside these areas. Keep in mind that tag names are the naming conventions that we use are much looser than the VB rules. So for example, if you have a tag or an alias with a space or some type of punctuation in it, Visual Basic can't handle those, so they may rename them, and they're called VB variable names. You should use these variable names in your code and not the actual tag names. Keep in mind that most of the tag names, tags, aliases, things like that, have their own properties and methods, so keep that in mind. And when you're developing your code, keep in mind some very basic rules. Syntax rules, for example, when you're declaring a variable and you want to get its value, you would use dot value as the code. When you want the tag name, you would use something dot tag and so forth. In the first example, the ace out tag at runtime, its value would equal the ace in's tag's value times 10, and that's a very simple example. Keep in mind also that times are used using the Microsoft rules more than the Py rules, and if you one example of that is the function now. If you've ever used Excel and or other Microsoft products and you want to signify now or runtime as a time to use, you would use now with the left and right parens, whereas in a Py calculation you might just use the asterisk. Also keep in mind that the units of measure for time are in days, so if I wanted to go back 24 hours, I would use the function now left right paren minus 1. That would take me back exactly 24 hours from runtime. However, if I only wanted to go back an hour, I would use the now left right paren and minus 1 over 24. That would tell me to go back only 1 hour. And again, this would be opposed to using the asterisk for now in Py and the asterisk minus 1h in Py. So there are some different rules, and it's a good idea to get used to those rules in Visual Basic. Also keep in mind that we have a lot of functions. Most of the calculations and performance equations that you can do in Py, you can also do in ACE. They just may be termed a little bit different. Like here's an example, ACEin.AVG, that's the average, and we're getting the average between now minus 124, which is an hour ago, and now.